This video is brought to you by Brilliant. While prepping my recent M2 iPad videos, I got hooked on researching new iPad apps that I could potentially integrate into my workflow. And I have shortlisted 10 apps that I intend to keep on my tablet, and I'd love to show them to you. By the way, feel free to recommend your recent app discoveries in the comments below or discuss them in my new chat room, which I'll talk more about in a moment. All right. Let's warm up with a simple app that I find priceless for my evening iPad sessions. It is called Noir, and it is fundamentally a dark mode toggle for Safari. Once installed, Noir needs to be activated as an extension to Safari. Once this is done, every light and white website becomes dark or black, depending on my preference. I can choose if I want to darken the website images and even create a schedule for activation which matters most to me. I've set it up to turn on automatically at 10 p.m. on both the iPad and iPhone, and I've kept all images as is, although having the ability to darken them is pretty cool as well. There are a few themes that I can choose from and even shortcuts for toggling the app on and off when necessary. Definitely one of my must-have apps. Moving on to some writing tools, there is the AI Writer. This is an app that I came back to after I got lost during device transitions. It's a writing app unlike no other I've seen before. First and foremost, it is focus-centric. Despite offering plenty of functionalities like connecting documents to one another, markdown, or the ability to move around docs via shortcuts, essentially being as efficient as possible, I came back to it for another reason, and that is the focus writing experience. When enabled, I am saved from all potential UI distractions and presented with interface zero, as I like to call it. In that mode, I write one sentence at a time, which allows me to focus on the flow of my written word. The built-in style checker also lets me eliminate cliches and filler words by striking them as I type. The script for this video was entirely written on the app, and I'm delighted I returned to it. The next writing tool that I absolutely love is called Substack. Substack is an email newsletter platform that I use to send my Sunday tech letters, as I call them. Substack is a publishing platform that can be used as a blog space that allows you to send newsletters, but there's so much more to it. Its simple interface and the ability to publish on the web have made it a game changer for writers of any skill level, because one can quickly and easily publish posts to the web or as emails in a matter of clicks. What I admire most is the simplicity of the interface. Instead of getting lost in HTML templates and unnecessary visual complications, Substack leaves room only for what matters most: writing and communicating with the audience. A post can be as simple as a combination of words and images, or as cool as a podcast where I can record and upload voice segments alone or as part of my newsletters. If you want to see an example of mix of text, visuals, and audio, you can check out one of my posts about monitor resolutions, which I'll link below. Feel free to subscribe to the newsletter while at it, and of course to this channel, because why not? Substack recently launched a new chat feature, which I turned on last Sunday, and few people have already joined the experimental thread, so feel free to hop along. Post-it is the next app, which, as you can guess, is all about post-it notes. Developed by the 3M company, this app embeds real-life post-it notes into the digital world, allowing me to create all sorts of post-it boards. Aside from creating digital notes, post-it can also scan analog notes, which is fantastic. Apple Pencil is of course supported, which ties everything together quite nicely. It's a great tool to transfer analog notes from a meeting into a digital board, where things can be moved around and organized on the go to help ideas flow. And there's a rhyme. I personally use it when gathering ideas for videos, primarily when organizing my calendar. Everything I'm planning is set in stone in Notion, but before that, I prefer to keep things visual and move around notes to see how everything might stack up. Another example would be digitizing actual sticky notes, which we use while prepping and collecting product ideas for contents like everyday carry or desk setups. With iPadOS 16.2, Apple introduced a new free app called Freeform. Freeform is a visual whiteboard that can gather all sorts of information in one place. Unlike Post-it, which is focused on Post-it notes, Freeform can easily collect sticky notes, images, text fields, drawings, vector shapes, and pretty much anything you throw at it in one endless canvas. Freeform is unique for a few reasons. Reason number one is that it has full support for the Apple Pencil, which, unlike paid competitors, makes it very powerful. Reason number two is not here yet, but it will come soon, and that is the ability to get together with people and collaborate on a Freeform while on a FaceTime call, and I think that will become very, very popular. If you want to know more about Freeform, you can check Chris's channel DailyTekk, as he deep dives into the various functionalities of the app. I'll link it at the end. Currently, I started using the app to gather ideas and mood boards for wallpaper concepts and new widget designs. Moving on to a graphic app. A recent discovery of mine was an app called Vectornator. Despite being an avid Affinity fan and pretty good at creating vector artwork in Affinity Designer, the iPad versions of the Affinity apps are a bit cumbersome, or so I realized when I tried Vectornator. It is clear that the interface of this app was built with the iPad in mind, and all the tools are fluid and laid out perfectly. For example, instead of having a fixed menu that takes up screen in real estate for inspector panels, menus change and appear according to what is selected. Shortcuts like Command plus and minus to zoom in and out work as well, and I'm very excited to explore the app further and potentially build an interface for an app that I've been throwing around in my mind. See, apps like Vectornator unlock new productivity opportunities because they can be used at any time, eliminating the need to use a dedicated computer or be tethered to a desk. Okay, so I'm not very good at organizing links, and I know that because I recognize lazy habits when I pin a link instead of placing it in its correct place. In an effort to build a sound library of useful links that I can always go back to, I purchased an app called GoodLinks. Despite sounding like an app many people would be familiar with, I just learned about it. What got me hooked up to the app is that it doesn't require an account. There's no registration involved, and in a world where you need to create an account to go to the bathroom, this sounded like something I could spend 10 bucks on. GoodLinks helps me save links and organize them neatly thanks to the provided iPad Safari plugins and the overall iCloud synchronization. What's more, all the links I save, I can later pull up in a reader mode, enjoying content at its best and free of ads. Whenever I stumble upon an article I can later refer to, I can press on the puzzle icon and select GoodLinks to save it. I can tag it, mark it as read, and even star it as important. The next app that I'm super excited about is called Portal. This is one of the most beautiful apps I've seen recently. It is an escape app that helps me enjoy beautiful sceneries and step away from the jam-packed sounds of life in a unique way. At a glance, it's just a white noise app, but in reality, it is much more, and that's why the developers call it immersive escapes. It can help you sleep, be productive, and most importantly, help you reduce stress in a beautiful mix of ambient sounds and immersive visual representations. With a library of 50 locations in the premium version and additional functionalities like breathing exercises, timers, and even smart bulb integrations, it's an app worth exploring. Just as immersive and unique are the next two games that I'd like to show you. Created under the same umbrella, they offer diverse approaches to achieve odd satisfaction. The first one is called Blek, and it's available as a standalone game or an Apple Arcade alternative if you have a subscription. Blek is a puzzle game that can be played with just a finger or the Apple Pencil, and the way I describe it is a line that comes to life that you have to control to pass through different levels of the game. It's full of funky and relaxing sound effects and visual experiences. The next game is called Frost, and getting lost in it is just as satisfying. You draw paths to guide flocking spirits to their home planets, or at least that's how it's described. I define it as a mind fidget spinner. Ending the gaming segment, I want to show you an old school style of app called Shadowblade Plus. Available on Apple Arcade, Shadowblade Plus is a fast-paced action game that provides an unpretentious storyline and a massive dose of fun, especially when playing with a controller. We're talking about ninjas, weapons, and silky smooth animations, which sometimes is all a person can ask for. The next app, and the app that I always go back to, is Brilliant. With thousands of different courses to choose from in science, math, and computer science, it's like a bicycle for the mind. Let's take a favorite of mine, the Introduction to Probability course. A lot can be done with abundant data, but how about when you lack enough of it? This course will teach you how to build models and make forecasts in order to make decisions with scarce data. In one of the fun examples, you need to answer the question, if an asteroid hit planet Earth, how likely is it that it will hit a city? You'll go on to narrow down the available data in small steps while everything in your head goes click. The lessons work with visual cues to make things as intuitive and as satisfying as possible. To get started with Brilliant, visit brilliant.org/thisise or click on the first link in the description below. The first 200 of you will get 20% off Brilliant's annual premium subscription with challenging new content added monthly. If you just got your iPad, or you're about to get one soon, check out my recent video on how I set up a new iPad, as it can give you good ideas on integrating focus modes and shortcuts into your workflow. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like and subscribe to the channel, as well as my newsletter. And as always, it's been an absolute pleasure. This is E, over and out.